which is the body of Christ, encouraged to follow the example of Jesus and anointed to serve him. Baptism is important and is exciting. It's also dramatic and deeply meaningful. As we prepare for Axel's baptism, we're going to pray. Let's do that now. Eternal God, your Spirit hovered over the waters in creation, and you brought your people through the passing of the desert sea, and your Son came to John to be baptized. Would you pour out your Spirit on Axel that you now meet in these waters, that he may enter Christ's tomb and be reborn, that he may die to all that is death and be brought to a new and living hope. This we ask from the same Jesus who lives and reigns with you in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Axel, do you come join us? Right, I have a verse for you, and as for the last time, I decided that I'm not going to try and memorise it, so it's on that bit of paper. 1 Timothy 6 verse 12 says this: fight the good fight of the faith, take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Hold on to that verse and walk with Jesus in his power. So we're going to ask Axel some questions, and by way of his answers, he's going to make promises. Axel, do you believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit?
I do. This is the God in whom I trust.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Saviour?
I do. He has redeemed me and called me by name.
Do you turn from sin, renounce evil, and intend to follow Christ?
I do. Christ is my way. He is the truth, and now he is my life.
Will you live within the fellowship of the church, and will you serve Jesus Christ in the world?
With the Spirit's help, this will be my witness.
We have heard of Axel's repentance and faith. You are called to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. I now baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.